Hi, I'm Boriana, and you're watching Art Unplugged. Good to see you again. What you see being dropped and smashed here is a 2,000-year-old Chinese urn from the Han Dynasty. The year is 1995, and it doesn't end there. In fact, this is just the beginning. Ancient urns will be dipped in paint and printed with the Coca-Cola logo. Art or vandalism parading as art? Yes, this video is about Ai Weiwei, an activist, dissident, and the most famous Chinese artist living today. A restless, extraordinarily creative man who actually put his life on the line to defend the freedom of expression, blurring the line between life, art, and activism. Ai Weiwei was born in Beijing in 1957. His mother was the writer Fao Ying and his father the famous poet Ai Qing, who Ai considers the greatest influence in his life. In 1958, his father was accused of being rightist during Chairman Mao's anti-intellectual campaign, and the family was exiled. Ai Weiwei spent his childhood in labor camps, where his father was made to do menial work. In order to survive as a child, Ai learned many of the practical skills that he would later apply to his art, such as making furniture and bricks. The family had been able to keep only one book, a large encyclopedia, Ai's only source of information and education outside the Maoist propaganda. After Mao's death, the family returned to Beijing, and in 1978, Ai Weiwei enrolled in the Beijing Film Academy, where he got involved with the budding avant-garde art scene. In 1981, he moved to the United States. He studied a bit, traveled around the country, and eventually settled in New York. There, he befriended the beat poet Allen Ginsberg and went to the same parties as Andy Warhol, whose work he adored. He also discovered Marcel Duchamp and Dadaism, and began transforming ready-made objects into art, including Hanging Man, a homage to Duchamp, made from a wire coat hanger. Ai Weiwei returned in 1993 to face a rather different China than the one he left. The wounds caused by the Tiananmen Square crackdown on pro-democracy demonstrators was still open. The country was modernizing on a massive scale. But modernization came at a price. Neighborhoods and entire cities were razed to clear way for the construction and industrial expansion. It is in that period that he produced his highly provocative work, Dropping a Han Dynasty Urn. One of the things that I was shocked to discover upon his return to China was how little objects of cultural patrimony were valued. They could be bought for next to nothing. There was a farmer sleeping on top of these two urns, waiting for someone to pay him a few hundred yuan, remembers Ai Weiwei. For him, that was a few months' salary, but even then, nobody wanted them. Dropping a Han Dynasty urn is as much a work of photography as a work of performance art. In each of the three frames, Ai looks directly at the camera in defiant awareness of the destructiveness of his act. There is more than one way to interpret this work. On the one hand, it can be seen as an expression of his dissent against a culture that wants to move on with little regard to its past. On the other, it can be seen as a reckoning with the inevitable destruction which comes with construction. But there is yet another way to look at it. Was dropping a Han Dynasty urn a true obliteration? Or let's put it this way, smashing it obviously was, but what about the resulting new artwork? Yes, we can view this work as the destruction of another artist's work, but Ai's act can also be seen as a sort of collaboration with the artist over thousands of years, a revival through repurposing, so to speak. Paradoxically, the destruction of the urn gives it a new lease of life it still exists for the public, but it has been transformed into captured film stills. And thanks to the notoriety of the artist, a piece of history that would otherwise gather dust somewhere becomes visible and relevant to us. In fact, it gains significance that surpasses its value as a highly prized antique. Do you agree? Let me know. I began collecting antiques, particularly ancient vessels and furniture, and converting them into contemporary artworks. This work consists of 886 traditionally handcrafted wooden stools. In China, every household had at least one of these wooden stools that were passed down to the next generation. But nowadays, the wooden stools have almost vanished, being replaced with plastic and aluminium. And this installation, titled Fragments, is composed of beams and columns from demolished 17th century temples. At first glance, the works appear chaotic and jumbled, but from above, Weiwei has created a unique 3D map of the intricate borders of China, commenting on the fragility of the country's foreign relations. I also did that with a more recent symbol of Chinese history, the bicycle, which in his childhood was a main means of transportation for the masses, and still is for many Chinese. This installation is titled Forever, and like in many of Ai's works, the title is a play of words with several meanings. Forever is the most popular brand of bikes in China, manufactured by a Shanghai-based company. The repetitiveness and the size of the installation allude to the mass production which fuels Chinese manufacturing industry. The word forever also alludes to circles and cycles, which sends us in the direction of history, even philosophy. And isn't each of these bikes a metaphor for a human being, one of the countless Chinese workers cycling to work and back every day? Forever also pays homage to this notorious work by Marcel Duchamp, who was one of Ai's early artistic inspirations. Despite of being repressed, beaten, and constantly monitored by the Chinese authorities, Ai is an artist who refuses to conform. He co-designed the bird's nest as the 2008 Olympic Stadium in Beijing became known. And though it brought him international fame, later he said that he regretted creating such a monument for the state and has never set foot inside a building. In 2008, the province of Sichuan suffered massive casualties in an earthquake, leaving 90,000 dead or missing. Over 5,000 of them were children, killed when poorly constructed schools collapsed on top of them. I was outraged to discover that this could have been avoided. What's more, the government was trying to cover up the reality. Ai Weiwei visited the region in the immediate aftermath and mobilized volunteers to gather the names of the dead and displayed them publicly. He also responded with art, buying out tons of twisted rebar from the wreckage, which was then straightened and assembled into this gigantic floor sculpture titled Straight. He arranged the bars in waves that resembled the oscillations in an earthquake on a seismograph. The fissures between them resemble fault lines. The thousands of individual components reference the individual lives lost, a typical feature of Ai symbolism. He also arranged 9,000 backpacks on the facade of the Haus der Kunst in Munich to represent the young lives lost. The words that you see are a quote from a victim's mother and read, "She lived happily for 7 years in this world." I find the discrepancy between the grim subject of the work and the bright colors typical of children's toys particularly touching. Ai's work goes beyond subjects related to China. To raise awareness of the plight of Syrian refugees, he wrapped the columns of Berlin's concert hall with salvaged refugee life jackets and covered his sculptures with thermal blankets. His latest project is a virtual reality work titled Omni. It reflects on different forms of displacement, animal and human, by focusing on displaced working elephants in Myanmar and Rohingya refugees in Bangladesh. But if there is one work of Ai Weiwei's that I wish I could see, It is the sunflower seeds. In 2010, I filled the enormous turbine hall of London State Modern with exactly 100 million porcelain sunflower seeds. Each life-sized seed was individually sculpted and hand-painted by craftsmen working in small-scale workshops. Poured into the interior of the turbine hall's vast industrial space, the 100 million seeds create the feeling of an infinite landscape. The meaning of this highly poetic work is deep and multi-layered. The sunflower is an important Chinese communist symbol. Chairman Mao compared himself to the sun and his people to sunflowers. In Beijing, sunflower seeds are a popular snack sold on the streets. So for Ai, they are linked with happy memories of his youth. But cast on the ground to be walked on, they evoke an oppressed, downtrodden society, far from the ideal of Mao's propaganda. The initial intention of the work was that the visitors walk on the seeds, which made the experience very special. Imagine the feeling under your feet and the sound. But that had to stop because there was also dust, which was deemed harmful for the museum visitors. There is a kind of poignant symbolism even in this unforeseen effect of the work, don't you think? Then porcelain is almost synonymous with China and historically has been one of China's most prized exports. By choosing this material for his sunflower seeds, Ai makes a stop and think again about the made in China phenomenon and the politics of cultural and economic exchange today. And the story of the making of the sunflower seeds itself makes us reflect on the handmade versus the mass-produced, on tradition versus industrialization. It goes even further, evoking thoughts about the relationship between the individual and the collective, and the human condition in general. Think of those 100 million tiny seeds against the vastness of the space. And then think of the power hidden in their multitude. What does it mean to be an individual in today's society? Are we insignificant or powerless unless we act together? And after all is said, to me the genius of this work comes from its ultimate simplicity. At the end of the day, it consists of one single element, a seed. Think about it. I hope you found this video interesting. Please like, share, and subscribe, hitting the bell so that you get notifications of my future videos. If you're interested to see my work as an artist, you can find me on social media. All the links are in the description below. I've recently opened an Etsy store, so you may want to have a look at that too. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you very soon. Bye.